Hi, welcome to RoboJax. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can use this dual axis XY joystick for Arduino. This can be used as a for game controller and for robotics, ARM, or some any other application that you wish. So what we do is that we will be able to detect the switch. So when you push it, this light is on, we will detect the switch. And also if you pay attention on the screen here, so now X and Y position, if I go to the right, it shows Y has moved. Go to the left, Y is 0, and then X, and then X forward, or somewhere in between. So you can do any movement that you want, and you see the value is reflected. So this video would be just to get the value, but also next, in the next video, I will have a actual screen to move a dot on the screen. But for now, for simplicity, this is a general introduction for this, so let's get started. So you can get the code by clicking at the link at the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. So you can get the code by clicking at the link at the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. So this is joystick XY or dual axis module. It's one of the interesting and easy to use module. This can be removed, and then let me just explain the pins first. So we have these pins here. So this will be connected to the ground, and then we are connecting it to 5 volt, this one, and then these two are variable X, which is connected for X, and then variable for Y, and then we have a switch. So this will go to switch. So inside this we have a variable resistor, something like this. Okay, so this has a housing, it's covered all, but it has a handle. So we have exact same thing here, and the handle is inside. So as if we have this here. Okay, so the handle is there. When you move this left and right, it rotates the potentiometer. Also, we have another one on this side, so we have two. What happens is that when you move this back and forth, you can see here, this is being rotated. So we are rotating this potentiometer, and the potentiometer has three pins. So when you rotate it, actually, you are putting the middle pin connecting to this value, and when you're rotating to the right, it goes from 5 volt, it comes to 0.5 and lower. So the value would be between 0 and 1023, so it's 1024 points. So when it goes left and right, when you don't touch it, it stays at the middle. That's why we always see around 500 something. So now this is the other one, so it goes this way. So when I move this back and forth, if I don't push it towards left or right, the other one will not be affected. So if I move this like that, so the other will not be affected. But we can go somewhere in between. You see, both of them are moving, or at any position that you wish. So all of those will be moving, and we will be able to read the position of X and Y. Then on this side we have a switch. So this is a switch that when you push the button, so this is a push button switch, which I have a separate video explaining it, and this switch is connected to this pin. Now, in order to eliminate putting extra resistor, I have defined a pin as a pull-up resistor, which I'm going to explain in the code. So this is the joystick. So the joystick is 26 millimeter, 25.9, so that is 26 millimeter, that's the width, and the length of it is 33.9, which is 34 millimeter. And without the cap, without this cap, the depth here is 14.5 millimeter. And if you want to know the all depth, including the cap, 32.2 millimeters. So first, from this 5 volts and the ground, I have taken the blue, the red here connected to this pin of my breadboard, and then the blue, which is ground, connected here. In your breadboard, my blue might be the other side, so it doesn't matter, I'm putting it with the blue. So this is the ground, and that's the red one is the 5 volts. And then this is connected to the ground and 5 volts in here. These two are these pins. Now we have VR X and variable resistor X, variable resistor Y. These two are directly connected to analog 0 and analog 1. Analog 0 and analog 1 are here, A0 and A1. They have been labeled here as A0 and A1. So they are connected in here. Then we have a switch. For a switch, we need a digital pin. So this is connected to pin 6 on this side. So these are all digital pins between 2 to 13. So it's connected there. If you want to monitor the LED and if the switch is pressed, then I use here pin 13 for the LED. So the pin that's coming to the LED, to the positive one, which is the long one. The long one is connected to the pin 13. And then from the short one, which is negative, 680 ohm. So anything less than 500, even 1 kilo will be fine, because you just need to see the light and it goes here to the ground. So let me explain the code here. We have defined a switch pin. So pin 6, you can put any digital pin between 2 to 13. So you can ignore this, it's not being used if you are not using a screen. And then inside the setup here, we are setting the communication for 9600 baud. And then here the switch, which is 6, this is as if I type 6 here. So input pull-ups, we do not just type input but pull-up, because we need this pin to be connected to the resistor with a pull-up resistor to the positive. So when you press it, it connects to ground and it acts for us. So this is very important, otherwise you need extra wire and resistor to make it work. And then pin 3, that's the output. This is optional if you need to display when the switch is pressed, and display that LED. And then inside the loop, which is start from here to here, A0 reads the input analog 0 and puts the value into X. So this will be between 0 and 1023, and then A1 is for the Y. And again, these two are, if you're using a screen, otherwise you can ignore it. But so this is the position of X, this is the position of Y. If you're using the screen, we say get the X, which has a value between 0 and 1023, and then convert it or map it, as we call it, between 0 and the width of the screen. So you don't have to do the calculation. This will do it for you automatically. So this is called mapping from one value, minimum maximum, to another value, minimum maximum. This value is defined in here. So if you're not using a screen, you can just delete this. And then here we read digital red and the switch pin. And the result of that will be stored in the S state or switch, so switch state. And then here we are printing the text X and then the X actual X. This X without a quotation is the value of position of X. And then we are printing this text because this is inside a double quote. And then we are printing after the Y, we are printing the position Y, which is this one. This X and this Y is printed. And here we can say if switch is low, which means when it's pressed, then put this text on the screen, or also set the pin 13 to high. So this will turn LED on. else, otherwise, turn the LED off. And then wait for half a second, 500 milliseconds, just wait for half a second, and this repeats continuously. So now let's have a look at the code. The value that you see is between the two values. So this is 1023 and 1023 that we have. Okay, so it just prints X and Y at the position. So if I press this fully on this side, you will see it goes 1023 for the Y and back to the average, which is at the middle 520. And if I go this way, it goes fully zero. So this back and forth will show, in this case, it's Y. So for the X, the same thing. If I go here, that goes 1023, leave it, it goes at the middle, which is 500, and then the other way would be zero. So the X and Y of this one is here correct, but also it depends on your orientation, how you put it. And now if I press the switch, so this, I'm pressing it and it shows here, and also here, when I press it, also the LED is on, and here it shows pressed. Now, if you're using the screen, then I can use the X position here instead of actual X value. So Y position. Now, let's say you have a screen that has the width of 600 and the height is 300, and you want to move, not the screen or anything. Let's say you're pointing a laser beam on a wall and you are trying to draw something between 600 and 300, and so you can do that, and here is the mapping that converts it, and this time if I upload it, you will get the actual between the values of your screen. So now you see the value, this is the middle of 600, so this is the 600 and the 300 is here for the Y. So if I press this fully on this side, you can read this here, that is 300, the maximum height of the screen. And if I leave it, it goes zero, and if I go back, so that is zero. At the middle, leave it, it will be 152. Now, this one will go between 0 and 600. If I push it back, it will be 600, leave it, and then that side zero. So the mapping is very useful to convert between the two values, because 0 and 1023 might not mean anything to you. So put your own value, and here you can just type the number, which I typed it there. So it makes it very easy to understand for your application. So this was introduction to this dual axis joystick. Please thumb up the video, please share it and subscribe, so you get updates when I upload other videos that this will be used with different type of displays. Thank you for watching.